everybody. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, God bless you. Say, this is the day the Lord has made. Yes, yes, yes. What a blessing to be in the house of the Lord. Can I have an amen? I say it again. What a blessing to be in the house of the Lord.
Amen.
We have some people for the first time here with us. Someone say, God bless you.
God bless you.
Amen. That's right. Oh, it's just a joy to be in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. How many of you walk on those sidewalks? Come on, somebody. Amen. Hallelujah. And hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Whew, we serve a faithful God. Someone say, He's faithful.
He's faithful.
Yes, He is. He's always faithful. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Well, the Lord has led me to this scripture. John 10. Most assuredly I say to you, he who does not enter the sheepfold by the door, but climbs up some other way, the same is as a thief and a robber. But he who enters the door, but he who enters by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the doorkeeper opens, and the sheep hear his voice, and he calls his own sheep by name, and he leads them out. And when he brings out his own sheep, he goes before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. Yet they will by no means follow the stranger, but will flee from him, for they do not know the voice of the stranger. Someone say, John 10. Someone say, I know his voice. The Bible just said here that we know the voice of the Lord. The voice of the stranger, we don't listen to that voice. We move away from that voice. That voice is trying to come in from another way. Jesus is the only way, come on, is the only life, come on, and is the only truth. Jesus doesn't have to come in or climb through a window, come on. He doesn't have to go through the back door, come on. He doesn't have to try to come on some other way, but he will come through the very entrance of the main door, because he is the door and the sheep hear his voice. Someone needed to hear that this afternoon. And I declare, lift your hands in the name of Jesus, that you hear the voice of the Lord. And it is his voice that will move your life.
Amen.
Come on, let's all stand. Amen. I want you to grab the hand of the person next to you right now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. One thing we do here at Living Faith is we unite together and we believe and we expect an atmosphere of faith, so that miracles, signs, and wonders will take place. Father, we unite as a family, and we thank you, Lord, for bringing us to your house today. We declare this is the day you've made. We as believers choose to be glad and never forsake the assembly of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, we hear your voice. And your voice is calling us, and it's a call to worship. So, Lord, for the next few moments, we're going to worship you in spirit and in truth. I pray for those that have needs in their life, I pray that as they grow in faith, Lord, you begin to heal and meet every need in the name of Jesus. I pray that as we believe, not doubt, Lord, that tonight we shall have those miracles assigned to us. Bless every family. Bless every person watching worldwide on our internet media. We declare the blessing of the Lord is upon this house in Jesus' name. And everyone said amen. Hey, listen, the altar is open. You know how we do here at Living Faith. If you want to sit, if you want to walk around and pray, if you want to grab somebody in prayer, you just want to come to an altar, I want you to get comfortable in the presence of God and know that this is His day. And throughout this hour, we're going to honor Jesus. Silence your cell phones. Turn them off. Let's focus on Him. Let no distractions distract you from your moment with the Lord. Worship Him right now in the name of Jesus. Come on, church.
King. You are my everything, and I will adore you. Around him.
you sing it, church. You are so holy.
You are holy.
Come on, sing it with the angels.
Holy. santo, santo, tres veces santo, tú eres santo, Señor.
Just say he's holy right now. Even in our imperfections, he is holy. Even in our fears and in our doubts and our worries, he is holy. Even in the midst of our uncertainties, is holy. In the midst of war and terrorists and failure, he is holy. The Bible says that he who knew no sin became sin so that you and I would become the righteousness of the Lord. He was holy. And he left his glory. And he came to earth. And he put on skin. And he took on the sin of the world. And he carried it. And God looked away when Jesus cried out, because he's holy and Jesus had the sin of the world. But our God is faithful, because in the midst of his agony, pain and distress and death, that third day he came up. I'm going to tell you right now, I don't know exactly where you are, what you're going through, or what you're fixing to walk through. But Jesus Christ, will be with you. And I feel you need to know that. I'm going to challenge some people right now. You might have to get out of your chair, but I want to challenge you. You don't have to stay at the altar, but you're going to sing this song one more time, Lewis, the holy part, both English and Spanish. Just sing it. And whenever you're ready, those that are here at the altar, you do it. But just whenever you're ready, I want to challenge people just to step in this altar and just declare he's holy. And you can go back to your chair. You want to stay, that's fine. I want to challenge you to do that among these songs that we're fixing to sing, because he's fixing to do something right now when you take that step of faith.
Holy, you are holy.
Santo, Santo. Santo, Santo, Santo.
Come on, church, just worship Him right now. Just worship Him with your language right now. Just worship Him right now. Come on, worship Him in English, in Spanish, in your holy tongue. Someone right now by their hand and just begin to pray right now where you are. Just pray in the name of Jesus. Say, I call you blessed. I declare you healed. I declare you the head, not the tail, above, never beneath. I speak blessings over your life. I speak blessings over your life. I speak every need met according to His riches and His glory. Come on, church. Come on. Grab someone else right now and declare, oh, I call you blessed. I call you supernaturally healed in the name of Jesus. I call you debt free in the name of Jesus. I declare that the Lord is moving mightily in your life in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, that you have begun a good thing, a good work in the lives of people. Hallelujah. Come on, grab someone else and declare, He is faithful. Come on. Come on, tell Him, He is faithful. He is a faithful God. He is a good God. He is a faithful Father. Hallelujah. And hallelujah. Because He's holy. Because He's holy. Come on, love on the person next to you. Just give them a hug or a handshake. Love on them right now. Slowly work your way back to your chair. Thank you, Father. In this house, that's the holiness of the Lord. How many of you feel that comfort right now? That's the holiness of the Lord. We are so close to heaven right now. Hallelujah. He said, your will be done on earth as it is. Come on. In heaven. Hallelujah. What are they doing in heaven? They're singing, holy is the Lord. Shoo. Thank you, Father, for your holiness in this place. Hallelujah. Someone just say, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. A Wednesday night in this place is filled up to overflow. What a blessing. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give the Lord a great hand clap. Come on, keep giving him a hand clap of love. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. You are Jesus, King of kings, Lord of lords. Hallelujah. Someone say, he's my Lord. Amen. Why don't you give our praise team a wonderful hand clap? Amen. Of love and honor. You don't clap for Lois or Sebastian or Matt or Yachty or Marky, whoever was up here. You don't clap. You clap for the gift that was given to Jesus. You know, hallelujah. Let's give all the men that have helped us with our construction, inside and outside, a great hand clap of honor. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Now the neighbor next to you came to church, so give them a hand clap. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. You say, well, what are we doing, Pastor? We're stirring up faith. Amen. We're stirring up honor. Hallelujah. We're giving God all the praise and all the glory. Hallelujah. Give me just a little bit more light, Miss Kim, right there behind you. And the Lord said, let there be light. And there was light. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah and hallelujah. Well, you do a lot of honoring in this church. That's right. We're a church of love. Amen. We're a church of honor. Come on. Stir up faith. Share his love. And live in his victory. Someone say faith. Say love. Say victory. That's what we're all about. Someone ever tell you, what's all that about living faith? What's all those cars over there? What's going on? Faith, love, and victory. Someone say amen. Amen. That's right. Someone told me the other day, man, Pastor, the first day I met you, man, it was over there in that school over there. And praise the Lord. You talk about faith. And praise God. 3 years later, you're still talking about faith. Well, it's a walk of faith. What else you want me to talk about? You want me to come up here and say, pues hermano, tú sabes que otro día no me andaban los trials and tribulations. How you say it in Spanish? Some tribulaciones. Hallelujah. Estaban bien grandes. No, hombre. No, I don't want to talk about, we're going to go through all that, but I'm going to talk about faith. Amen. I'm going to talk about faith. Hallelujah. I'm going to talk about faith. Someone say faith. We're going to share love. Come on. We're going to stretch out to people and tell someone next to you, I love you. Glory to God. Yeah, that's right. I love you. We'll talk about the love of Jesus and also declare we're going to walk in victory. Walk in victory. That's the vision of this church. We walk by faith and not by sight. No greater love than there was in one that lays down his life, and that is Jesus. Love casts out all fear. Come on. And victory, well, he rose from the dead. Amen. Our God is not dead, but he is. He's alive. He's not dead. He's alive. So he's victorious. And we are to live in that victorious realm of his grace. I'm no victim. Come on, somebody. I don't have a victim mentality. Come on, somebody. I don't live poor me, poor me. Come on, somebody. I live the victory of the life of Jesus Christ. I'm not a beggar. I'm a believer. Come on, somebody. Tell your neighbor, we're not beggars. We're believers. Hallelujah. I don't got to beg. I just got to believe. Glory to God. Whew. Hallelujah. Somebody receive it right now in the name of Jesus. I receive it in the name of Jesus. Want us to go to the book of Matthew tonight for the next few moments. And I know there are some children in the house, and that's good. We love everybody. They need to hear the word of God. Amen. God is good. I love Team Storm is here, Miss Kim. Team Storm, amen. With Abel and everybody. She brought the whole youth group. Praise the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Good to see the Martinez family here. They're getting filled up. Amen. Good to see the Benavides family here. They're getting filled up. Amen. Good to see the Garcia family. They're getting filled up. Amen. Good to see the Sanchez family. They're getting filled up. Good to see the Diaz family. They're getting filled up. The Llewellyn family. They're getting filled up. The Gonzalez family. They're getting filled up. Come on, somebody. The Velasquez family. They're getting, the Linares. They're getting filled up. Amen. Who else did I miss? Let me see here. Right? Huh? Yeah, they're getting filled up. Praise the Lord. Figueroa, they're getting filled. Rodriguez, they're getting filled up. Mendez, they're getting filled up. Come on. Llewellyn's getting filled up. Come on. Let me see. 1, 2, 3. Say your last name. 1, 2, 3. There you go. You're getting filled up. Amen. Hallelujah. Now say Jesus. That's right. He's the one that's filling you up. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Don't want to leave nobody out. Are you there in Matthew chapter 14? Matthew chapter 14. We're going to start with verse 22. Praise the Lord. 14:22. Immediately, someone say now. Snap your fingers. 1, 2, 3. Now. The Bible says here in verse 22, immediately Jesus made his disciples get into a boat and go before him to the other side while he set the multitude away. And when he had sent them away, he then went to the mountain and began to pray. And he was there alone. And the boat that the disciples were in were now in the middle of the sea. And it was being tossed by the waves, for the wave was contrary. Now it was about the fourth watch. Someone say 3 a.m. Say 4 a.m. Say 5 a.m. 6 a.m. The fourth watch was that time frame right there. So it was about the early morning. I won't be surprised God wake you up at 3 o'clock. Come on. I won't be surprised God wake you up at 4, 5, 6. Wake you up supernaturally, tossing and turning. You can't go to bed. Why? Because you got to pray. Come on, somebody. Why? Because you got to talk to him. He got a word for you. Now, on the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went to them walking on the sea. How did he go to them? Walking on the sea. How was Jesus going to them? He was walking on the sea. Jesus is a water walker. Amen. And when the disciples saw him walking on the water, walking on the sea, they were troubled. And they said, "It is a ghost." And they cried out in fear. Someone say fear. We're going to stop right there. Tommy, throw up those scriptures real quick about fear. We're going to read some scriptures about fear. Isaiah 41:10. "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." Psalm 56:3. "Whenever I'm afraid, I will trust in the Lord." Someone say amen. Amen. That's right. Amen. Let me see the next scroll. Thank you, Jesus. That you got those. All right, that's good. Praise the Lord. He's filled up. That's good. Here, I got them written down right here. I'm going to read you some more scriptures in faith. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God is our refuge and my strength. He is my help when I'm in fear. Psalm 46, verse 1. The Lord is with me. Say, he's with me. I shall not be afraid. What can man do to me? The Lord is with me. He's my helper. Psalm 118, verse 6 and 7. Fear not. The Lord will always be with those who trust in him. Proverbs 29:25. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who have reverence towards the Lord, and he delivers them out of their natural fear. Psalm 34:7. But even if you suffer or doing what is right, God will reward you. So do not worry and don't be afraid of the little threats around you. 1 Peter 3:14. I prayed to the Lord and he answered me and he took those fears away from me. Psalm 34:4. I can go on and on and on talking about fear. Someone say faith trumps fear. What does that mean? It trumps it. It becomes over fear. This passage of scripture is just like Mark chapter 6, starting with verse 45, when we read about Jesus Christ coming to his disciples walking on the water. Well, I want to talk for a few moments tonight about our vision, your vision. The Bible says here that Jesus, Matthew chapter 14, 22, that Jesus sent his disciples to cross to the other side while he stayed back and he prayed and he visited and he sent the multitudes away. As it became late or early in the morning, the fourth watch, 3 to 6 a.m., Jesus began to walk on the water to the other side. Seeing the disciples in the middle of the sea being tossed back and forth, he then came to them. He saw their struggle. He saw what they were going through. He saw their pain. He saw their discussions. He saw their issues. He saw their need, and they needed help. Someone say, I always need help. Come on. God has never asked us to be alone. That's why he said, I'll never leave you nor will I forsake you. You're always going to need my help. If someone thinks they can do life without Christ, you're going to do life and end up somewhere without the glory of God. So Peter, we're going to talk about his faith. We're going to talk about his fear. And we're going to talk about his future. They saw a ghost, is what the Bible says. They saw a ghost. They were afraid. They saw Jesus, or they saw a figure coming on the water to them. And they were afraid, and they yelled out, and they cried in fear, and they said, it is a ghost. Fear changes your vision. Did you hear that? Now here's men that have been with Jesus for 3 years. They've walked with him, talked with him, sailed with him, ate with him. They've prayed with him. They've seen all the miracles with him. They've been a part of Jesus. How many of you know someone that you can see them from a mile away and you know their walk? Huh? Is this Juan? Is this Felipe? Is this that's Mark. They have a distinct walk about them, huh? Huh? They got a little swag. Come on, somebody. Huh? You see somebody in the mall, you whistle. Hey! You recognize them, right? Because you know them. You've been around them. You've talked to them. They may even be your neighbor. You know, these men knew Jesus. Come on, somebody. But see, in the midnight hour, or when they were in their turmoil, in their fear, their vision of Jesus was a whole lot different. Come on. They didn't see Jesus. They saw a ghost. You see, fear will always cause you to see differently. You'll never see the light in the tunnel if you live in fear. You'll never see the hand of God reaching down and grabbing you if you live in fear. Come on. All of us have been in that tunnel before. Come on. You've all had situations in our life. We've all have gone through some things in our life. I like someone, they put it on Facebook. Come to church, no perfect people allowed. Amen. Praise the Lord. So they were in fear and they cried out and they began to yell. And what happened? One person started crying. One person started fearing. And what happened now? Because that one person began to fear. It's like a chain or a domino. Boom, 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 boom. Everyone in that boat, all 12 of them, grown men, come on somebody, fishermen who had been in the sea, they've been in the turmoil, they've been in the waves back and forth, professional swimmers. Come on. Here's Peter, not afraid of no man, not afraid of nothing. He was a boastful individual, a man of he was just very, very bold, very loud, outspoken, no fear. Remember, he's the one that told Christ, "I'll die before you." He's the one that took off the dagger and cut someone's ear off. Remember? That's Peter. He's the one that left all to follow Jesus Christ. He's the one that Jesus Christ told him, "Do you love me?" "Yes, I love you." He told him 3 times, "Feed and tend to my sheep." This is Peter. This is Peter who said, "Nobody's going to take you away from me. I'll go with you. I'll stand up for you." This is Peter. But in the midst of that uncertainty, they couldn't see clear because of their fear. They all began to shout and cry. So someone needs to hear that tonight. Your fear doesn't just affect you. It affects your family. It affects where you work. It affects your finances. Come on. It affects your faith. It affects your healing. It affects everything. Because no longer are you seeing Jesus. No longer are you seeing, or am I seeing healing, but I'm seeing sickness. Come on. Because fear gripped me. What did the disciples see? They know Jesus didn't change his hairdo. He didn't change the style of clothes he was wearing. Come on. The same Jesus they saw with the multitude was the same Jesus they saw coming from the multitude on the water walking to them. But what happened? They'd never seen that before. Remember, they knew Jesus had power. They didn't know he was the power. They knew he was Emmanuel, Christ with us, but they needed to know he was the Christ, the God. That's what they needed to know. So when Jesus Christ came walking on that water, fear gripped them and they began to blink their eyes and rub their eyes and see different. And that I'm going to stay on that because someone in here needs to hear that. Fear makes you see different. You don't see your miracle. You don't see your blessing. You don't see what's coming next. You don't see how hard God is working on your behalf. You don't see the angels coming and descending and ascending from heaven and helping you. You don't see it because fear has changed your vision. Come on, somebody. It's changed your vision. "Well, I can't do that. Well, I don't have an education. Well, I'm not ordained. Well, I'm not this. Well, I'm not that." Fear has gripped you in some way, and it's held you, come on, from seeing Jesus. You see, fear doesn't come from God. Fear is the enemy's greatest weapon against our faith. It'll cripple our faith when fear comes in. But Peter had faith. He had so much faith that he told Jesus here in the text. He said, "If it is you," even in the midst of his doubt, he still had faith. Come on. He said, if it is you, he said, tell me to come out. Tell me to get on the water with you. Tell me to get out of this boat. Tell me to come out and walk with you. So what did Jesus say? Huh? Hold up now. Here's a guy who was scared. Here's a guy who was just crying. Here's a guy who was just on the verge of throwing the towel in. Here's a guy who was just saying, I can't see clear anymore. I thought this is what God was wanting me to do, but really I just don't know. Come on. Who's been there before? Huh? Yeah. Right. So Jesus clears up the vision and he says, don't be afraid, it's me. And so Peter says, if it is you, still doubting, tell me to come out there. He was the only one out of all 12 disciples that said, tell me to go out there. Maybe he was the best swimmer. I don't know. Maybe he was just a little guinea pig. You try it first. Huh? Maybe he was just the guy that said, you know what? I got the pride. I'm going to do it. I don't know. But he did it. He took that step. Come on. What does the Bible say? When you draw near to him, he then draws near to you. God begins to meet your needs the moment you draw closer to him. So Jesus said, come. And what did Peter do? He stepped out the boat. Come on, somebody. And he began to walk on his fears. Someone say, the devil is under my feet. Say it again. Say, my fear is under my feet. Get some old tennis shoes. You know the tennis shoes you wear all the time? I challenge you to write with a permanent marker on the bottom of your foot, your shoe, old shoes, you know, ones you wear a lot. Put your greatest fear underneath that sole. Let it serve you as a reminder that your fear is under your feet. That you're not controlled by your fear. Come on. Your fear is not moving your emotions. Come on. Your fear is not moving your dreams. Come on. No, it's under my feet. I'm walking on my fear. I'm walking on my fear. I'm walking on my fear. Peter was walking on his fear. He kept on looking at Jesus. What does the Bible say here as we read? Verse 29, so he said, come. And when Peter had come down out of the boat, he walked on the water to Jesus. But when he saw that the wind was very boisterous, he was afraid. Okay, so he was walking on his fear, which was the water, right? See, the wind was contrary to the boat, and the sea was contrary to the boat. So the boat was rocking back and forth. But right here, the Bible says the wind, what he felt. Come on. What was pushing him. Come on. Just like the devil, like a bully, gonna push you. Come on. Man, tell the devil, get off me. Tell the devil, get off me. Come on. Just like that devil gonna push you. The moment, how many of you been there before? The moment you take a step of faith, the devil's right there to push you back. Huh? Huh? Or is that just pastor? Huh? 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 Moment you take a step of faith, you know who else is going to take a step with you? The enemy. He's defeated though, but he's going to try to trip you. Come on. He's going to try to make you fall. He's going to try to push you down. And it's just like that wind, trying to push Peter down. So what happened? He took the bait. So what did Peter do? He sunk. He focused back on the fear and not on the faith in Jesus. What happens when we focus on our fears? We fall. What happens when we focus on our fears? We sink. Come on. We sink. He was sinking. The Bible didn't say he was swimming. If I was thrown out in the ocean, believe me, I'm going to start swimming. Regardless of the waves, I'm going to start swimming because I know how to swim. No, but they would call me Jaws. I'd start swimming. Do you think Peter, being a professional fisherman, do you think he knew how to swim? Absolutely. Why didn't he start swimming? Because he was in fear. What does fear do? It cripples you. You can't even move. So what happens? You become like a rock and you sink. Come on. Come on. Because see, fear puts weights on you. How many of you ever had burdens, huh? And you just feel so burdened, like, man, I feel like I can't do it anymore. I can't take it anymore. What's happening? You're sinking. Why? Because there might be some fear right now. So you're sinking. Peter sunk. He sunk. And the moment he sunk, what happened? What did Jesus do and what did Peter say? Come on. Immediately, the Bible says, when verse 30, when he cried out and he said, Lord, someone say Lord. The word Lord right here in this text means all authority. He's saying, I don't want you to be my teacher right now. I don't want you to be my friend right now. You are my Lord and you have all authority to save me. Come on. In our time and our fears, you know what? I don't need a best friend. I don't need a buddy to cry on. Come on, somebody. I don't need a blankie. Come on, somebody. And I don't need a pacifier either. I need Jesus to heal me, to set me free, to save me. That is who I need, who is all authority. And I'm done. You can close your Bibles. I see the time. He said, Lord, save me. Look what the Bible says. And immediately Jesus stretched out his hand. Okay, let me just do a quick analogy here. Mark, come over here and just lay on the floor right there. Just lay down. Lay down right on the floor. Just don't go to sleep. The Bible says immediately. When's immediately? Someone snap your fingers. 1, 2, 3. Now. Jesus stretched what? His what? So if he stretched, Jesus was all man, right? Jesus didn't have like a go-go gadget, right? You ever seen that Inspector Gadget? That's old. He didn't have Batman's belt. Come on, somebody. Take out all these gadgets. He didn't have an extraordinary arm. Come on. Jesus was all man and his arm was about 3 feet. So if immediately Jesus was there to pick him up, where was Jesus?
Just an arm length away. Peter, walking on the water, arm length apart. Jesus was right there. But the devil, listen, was right there too. And the devil was pushing it, pushing the wind. But what has pushed us today?
Yes, sir.
Terrorism has pushed us today. They try to bind us and say, we have no freedom. You have freedom. In Christ. In Christ, there's no chance.
Yes, sir.
People at work try to bind us. Failures, insecurities, emotions, situations that happen, they push us and push us and push us away from Jesus. Jesus is just an arm. He's 3 feet. 3 feet. 3 feet. Peter, see Jesus. Took his eyes off of Jesus. I'm going to tell you this. Jesus never takes his eyes off of you. Because if Jesus would have taken his eyes off of Peter, he would have lost Peter. Because Peter was sinking. Come on. Was sinking. He took his eyes off of him. Before Peter took his eyes off of Jesus. Jesus, come on, say immediately. 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 1, 2, 3, go. Immediately, Jesus. Immediately, Jesus, when he said, Jesus, save me. That's what the Bible says. If you confess with your mouth and you believe in your heart, immediately shall be saved. No longer are you bound for hell, but you're bound and on your way to heaven. See, he said immediately, and Jesus immediately picked him up. How close are you to this?
That's what the Lord showed me. He never takes his eye off of you. We might. We might. But he never does. He's watching us now. He's watching you when you leave. And he's watching you every day. Let's lift the hands to heaven. Father, we bless you. And we thank you for your word. We thank you that in the midst of our fears, our trials, or whatever we're going through, we lean on faith. We operate through faith. Because we know that it's faith that pleases you. In the name of Jesus. And everyone said amen. Jesus, after picking up Peter, you would think Jesus would have said, wow, well, yes. You actually took that first step. Well, I'm so proud of you, mijo. Oh, qué chulo. So grateful. You took that step. No, what did Jesus do? He rebuked him. After Christ saving him, you would have think he would have gave him a big old warm towel, right? Get warm, mijo, get warm. Empaca, empaca. What did Jesus do? Ye of little faith. Where is your faith? Why? Because see, you're born again. You know Jesus. But salvation doesn't just happen the moment you get saved. It's a walk of faith. It's a walk of faith. And every day, we have to live and turn our hearts to Him. Because He lives. Amen. God bless you. Come on, give the Lord another great hand clap. Hallelujah. We love you, Jesus. And we bless your holy name. Hallelujah. I'm going to invite the team to please come up. We're going to pick up an offering at the end of our services. As always, we lift up an offering for the Lord. And what a blessing it is to give to His house. Amen. I am so happy that we have 100% tithers in this house. We have 100% givers in this house. We know the blessing of the gift. Our time, our talent, and our treasure. And we know where our seed is planted. We don't throw our seed, we sow it. Come on, somebody. Someone say, don't throw it, sow it. Yeah, we sow our seed. If you need an offering envelope, just lift your hands right now. And they'll get to you right now in the name of Jesus. But we want everyone to believe with us. Believe with us. We're believing God for just some more things that we need for the kingdom of God. And your offering tonight is going to help us move forward in the kingdom of God. And we're so blessed to have a church that supports and honors the vision and sees the vision growing. As you can see, this house on a Wednesday. Come on, somebody. It's filled up. Amen. To God be the glory. But not only with bodies, because who's taking count? But we're filled up with faith. We're filled up with love. We're filled up with victory. And an assurance knowing that God is with us. Who can be against us? Hold your seed in your hand as you continue to sow and believe with us. Concrete's coming. Hallelujah. We got our first truck in. It laid what it needed to lay. Thank you, Jesus. Walkways of faith. We got more concrete trucks coming. Come on. Someone came in the property and said, Pastor, I see sidewalks all around the whole property. I said, thank you, Jesus. Amen. So to God be the glory. Oh, but no. Don't get doubt around me. I like faith. That was faith. Hallelujah. So Lord, we bless this seed in the name of Jesus. Come now and sow.
Give thanks to the Lord, our God and King. His love endures forever. For He is good, He is above all things. His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. Stretched arm, His love endureth forever. For the life that has been reborn, His love endureth forever. Oh, sing praise, sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. Forever God is faithful. Forever God is with us. Forever.
Come on, church, lift your hands right now as we believe and as we stand in faith and bless this seed. Father, we thank You for the seed sown. Fertile ground, Father. Reaps a harvest, Father. Hundredfold in the name of Jesus. We thank You, Lord God, for more souls to be saved. We thank You, Lord God, for more people to say yes to Jesus and live for Him. And I thank You, Lord, for every church and every pastor Lord, in every ministry as they continue the work of faith in Cotulla and every area as we minister the gospel of the Lord. We declare this seed supernaturally blessed in Jesus' name. And everyone said amen. Come on, give the Lord a great hand clap of honor. Amen. Thank you to our ushers. What a blessing. Now I'm going to stay and I'm going to pray for you, my wife and I. If you need special prayer and you've come for prayer, I'm going to pray for you separately. Church is going to be over, but I'll stay here and I'll pray for you. Let me just leave with a couple of announcements. We're so excited that 2016 is right around the corner. And we made the announcement this Sunday that starting January 2016, every Sunday at 9:30, we will be having a all-Spanish ministry unto Jesus. Amen. The ministry will be bilingual as far as the word. Pray for me and everyone that's going to be helping. But the songs and everything in Spanish. So if you're an early bird and you want to say, you know what, I'm going to come to church early in the morning at 9:30, praise the Lord. And at 10:30, you're released, praise the Lord. And then at 10:45, we're going to hold a second service. And that's going to be an all English service for Jesus. And I know most of you, as you do even today, you come for the Bible study and you stay for the church service. What a blessing. You might even stay for both services. Double portion. That's fine. So it's going to be great. Amen. We're signing people up to help. We're going to need, two sets of hands, two sets of teams. Just two. He sends them two by two. Amen. And so we're excited about that. And also on the 23rd of December, and I want you to mark your calendar. 23rd of December, that's just 2 weeks. 2 weeks from now, on a Wednesday, we're going to be having a Christmas dinner in this church. And also, we're putting together songs and just worship and just blessings for you. So invite people. We're going to have it banquet setting. Come casual, you know. I think I wanted to serve ham. I just thought ham and a nice pineapple, but some ladies got together and they said, ham, we want carne guisada. We want rice and beans and tamales and brumelos and menudo. And I said, wow. Said, and potato salad. Praise the Lord. I said, pues, if y'all are making it, I'll eat it. Praise the Lord. So that's a good thing. Amen. We love you. God bless you. If you need personal prayer, you're able to come and receive prayers. Good to see our wonderful family. Brother Freddy Gonzalez and your wife. I don't know your name. Help me with your name. Oralia. It's a blessing seeing y'all here. Another Oralia. Praise the Lord. We have 4 or 5, so it's a blessing. Amen. Well, greet each other in the name of the Lord. God bless you. We'll see you Sunday. Hallelujah.
Like a fire shot up in my bones, I want the world to know you are God. And with a passion burning deep within, I want the world to know that you your presence come and saturate every part of me, make me new. Let your spirit come and move within, fill me once again. I need more, Jesus. I'm for you, Jesus, I'm hungry. For you, Jesus, I'm longing. For you, Lord, you are all. I'm lifted.